So I started a video yesterday and I didn't get to finishing it because yesterday just got kind of crazy and planted like 40 acres only. So as you can see, I'm getting the planter. So we've been rolling here quite a bit, got quite a bit of land done. It's kind of an interesting spring so far. Just little problems here and there that keep coming up and hard to keep videoing. I still gotta offload my GoPro yet and get all the footage off there, and I still got videos to edit. Yeah, so not stopping on you guys here. Now we're trying to locate a hub for one of the transport wheels on the vertical till. Jeremy was VTing yesterday and he pulled into the next field and he set the vertical till on the ground and he was able just to pull the whole entire wheel off with the hub on the wheel. He's lucky because he was on a pretty busy highway, and it would have been a bad day if that came out. So fortunately he caught that. So we ended up working some bean ground yesterday with that. Got 120 acres of corn ground to put in yet here. And then we're probably just gonna switch over to beans for the time being. Just to get ourselves, just get some bean ground put in. And then we got some corn, it's on some wetter ground here that we'll put in, and should be approaching the end. Got the sprayer working, the pump ended up going bad on it, so we had to get a new pump and hydraulic motor for that as well, which is no big deal, but yeah, so far the thing is actually working pretty good. So which reminds me, I gotta make a phone call for the auto steer, try to get that figured out. So but all right, let's roll for the day. One there, one above that, and then one above the one, one up on the hill, one down there, and then another one right here. And then I'm in this field, which is the bigger one on this side of the road. So, which everything on this side of the road is corn, and it's all that's gonna be done here today. So, we're putting in a 99 day here. This is 49 deep. 441 from Jung's, and we're putting it in at 34,000 seeds per acre. Don't mind the starter there, it's functioning properly. We're just having issues with the VFI HD units correlating with this monitor, so it is a known issue. So we're not the only ones supposedly dealing with it, so but we are fairly positive that it's putting down what it's supposed to be. We actually have our starter set for, we have our starter set for 4 gallons to the acre on this farm, so. But after this field, I got a couple more in the back, or a few more. I got three more to do after this here, but they're all 3, 4, 5 acre fields. So, but 99% singulation. I have my downforce set to 90 pounds. I could probably come up with that here, but I was running into issues up there where you see that grass. So it's not, the ground contact wasn't up the par. So we're at 98%. So after this, we're gonna head down south, 10 miles south, and go to a farm that we're going to be no-tilling into a cover crop. So that should be interesting. That's the first time this This would be the first time we've no-tilled into a cover crop with this planter, so... and I would say, you know, the stuff is probably a foot or so tall, so... It'll be interesting. It did get burnt down, so... we have a couple fields like that to do this year, so... It'll be interesting to see. I'm kind of looking forward to seeing what this machine, or how this planter does in it, so... I've ran no-till with this, you know, quite a few acres of no-till with this planter, and it ran it flawlessly, but, you know, and then we do a lot of till. They're fairly tilled soil, like vertical till. We've been using the vertical till quite a bit for corn ground just because it's making a more even seed bed. It doesn't necessarily... level out the bottom like the soil finisher would, and it also doesn't make it as pillowy as the soil finisher does. But what I'm looking for is the evenness. And until we get a different soil finisher, I'm leaning more towards using that thing. The only thing I'm not going to use it in is ground that we detailed the fall before, in the previous fall, just because it doesn't get down deep enough get everything leveled off the way it should, so from just what I noticed, but could very well work, and it probably does, but soil finisher, when you're looking at the bottom of the seed bed, it makes a more even floor to the seed bed. So we got it down to 3 inches, we're putting corn in at 2 inches, just we have plenty of moisture, you know, up in the upper levels. So this is definitely a first for me. So in the past we've planted into, or no-tilled into, say rye. Stuff we did was with the Kinsey, and that was taken off for a forage. So we were planting into, you know, basically a couple inches of stems. But we're planting into probably foot tall, roughly standing rye, or rye mixed with some other stuff. So this might also be wheat. It seems like wheat. I can't remember what he said. So we are customing this for a buddy of ours, and always like trying new things. So I'm learning quite a bit here as I go. We still have good singulation, which is good. I finally got my downforce under control, which I was having issues with that. So, still having our starter issue. It is putting down the right amount, but it's not reading right. I don't exactly know what's going on. It has to do with the Gen 3 not correlating with the V-Apply HDs correctly. And then we have the flow sense, but we turn those off just to get us by. Otherwise, I'd have a screen up here every 2 seconds. So, or a warning screen up here every 2 seconds. But so I have my row cleaner set in at 10 psi down. We're just trying to clear a small way for this. I was running it a little bit higher, then I came to find out that that was not really working, and then I called my precision guy, and he kind of threw me in the right direction. I was putting too much pressure down on him that I was lifting the actual bar of the planter up, and then that was taking force off of the row units. So, but we got the downforce down to 120 pounds. My margin is now kind of hanging around in that 20 area, but I guess I'm worried about good ground contact, and the seed is getting placed in the right spot. I've been out of this thing like 3 times now. I'm just making, I I know the markers on this planter. I honestly should have took and went in and set a boundary around the entire field on here and did a curved thing and kind of auto-steered my headlands, but I was kind of stupid and didn't do that, so I was squinting, trying to find where the marker is, or where the marker was. I have a love-hate relationship, more of a hate relationship with them. There's not enough weight, so they don't dig in enough, and they're kind of flimsy, to be honest with you. The toolbar itself, I love it. Yeah, it'd be nice if it had a little bit more weight to it, but this is the only thing that I'm having issues with. All of our other ground is tilled, so eventually down the line, depending on if we do it with this toolbar or not, if we put the conceal on this toolbar, this will have tanks on the outer wings, so that'll kind of help put a little bit more weight, because all the row units that are kind of giving me issues seem to be coming from the wings. So at that point in time, you know, if we do it with this toolbar, that's what we'll end up doing. So when it comes time to a situation like this, this toolbar is not necessarily heavy enough. So we don't do a lot of this, you know, there'll be 100 acres or so every year, if any. Definitely not afraid of planting into this at all. So there's an albino deer up there. Totally white deer. I don't know how well you guys are gonna see that. I don't know if you see that white blob right there. It's a white deer. It is kind of cool planting into this, so. But once we get up to the other pass up there, we'll get out and we'll see what this thing is doing. So I like to check as I go, unless I need to stretch, because I've been in a tractor all day, so. Alright, so. Find our seed here. Got our trench. Yep, there's one right there. So we are at our 2 inches. To go wrong and not really see it, so now this is actually working a lot better than it was, so kind of got this dialed in. Now I know what I have to do. So all as I know, this tractor does need some more horsepower for this planter, and it has enough hydraulic pressure when it's at a higher idle, so gotta kind of run them at a higher idle. It'd be nice to have an IBT, or it, CVT or CVX for this, just to keep a higher idle but be able to kind of mess with your speed a little bit. So, but I am happy with that C trench there. It is fluffier than what I was dealing with down there. Granted, this is some lighter ground up here than it is down that way. So, the most amazing thing with a new planter like this is you pay so close attention to what's all going on here and all the fine tuning you can do that you spend more time trying to fine tune it than you actually do, you know, planting. Well, obviously we're planting as we go, but you know, since I have an auto steer and I'm trying to take and I can sit here and watch this, you know, now I try to fine tune it more. I should probably just leave it alone, let it do its thing. But planting is the most important task, you know, that you have to get right, because you only can do it once. So, and coming back and replanting really isn't the best thing. So, you got one shot and you want to try to make it as good as possible. This is why we like having the new technology, just so we can see what's all going on. But I am going to wrap this video up here, so I'm going to keep rolling here and try to go the rest of the night, try to get this stuff wrapped up so we have a clear way of getting our corn in tomorrow, or the rest of the corn in tomorrow. So before it rains on Friday. So in the next video, you guys will see me tomorrow. So I hope you guys enjoyed.